Let's begin with the crisis in Venezuela. Mitch?
It really is crisis mode, Mark. We're talking about the Western Hemisphere's worst humanitarian crisis in recent memory, including last weekend, at least 3 people killed, hundreds more injured, as members of the opposition tried to defy a government ban to bring in food supplies, hygiene kits, nutritional supplements. The government doesn't want people in Venezuela to get this stuff. And this is part of this whole long economic meltdown that goes back 20 years from when Venezuela first put in Hugo Chavez as the socialist leader. The current president, Nicolas Maduro, follows in Chavez's lead. There's been a lot of pressure mounting on him to step down. There have been 3 million people fleeing that country.
Most of the Western nations.
Yeah, 50 countries, including the U.S., most of Latin America, most of Europe, calling on Maduro to step down. 50 countries have said that the actual real leader right now is the head of the National Assembly, Juan Guaido. They are supporting him, hoping that he will take power. So basically, you have a lot of chaos going on. The Secretary of State, Mike Pompeo, has said that the U.S. is going to help stand with the people who are trying to see reform and are going to stand against anyone who stands in the way of restoration of peaceful democracy, which could include those Cubans who are embedded within the Venezuelan government.